It's been a year since I created this bottle ecosystem. I was not planning to make a video about it, but something weird happened. These tiny things in my finger are bladder snails, and they are so small because they just hatched. I left them in the bottle with soil, water, and plants, everything they will need to thrive. They quickly developed into adults. It took less than 30 days for them to reach their max size, and they even started mating and laying eggs inside the bottle, which is a bit murky because they are siblings. But that's not the weird thing. After 3 months, I noticed both of them had an appendix in the left side of their bodies. I've been keeping these species for years, and I'd never seen that before. Since it happened to both of them, I knew it was something related with the environment they were living in. Although they are aquatic animals, they have lungs, and they need to reach the surface every now and then to take a breath of air. So after 100 days of respiration, they just run out of oxygen. And here, the shape of the bottle is to blame. The narrow opening doesn't allow much ventilation, and since carbon dioxide is denser than oxygen, it's been accumulating for a while. But these snails are used to living in ponds, so they obviously have alternative strategies to get their oxygen when the water's surface freezes during winter. Under these stressful circumstances, the snail's mantle is modified, creating this new appendix. This structure works like an improvised gill. Because it's super thin, it has a big surface area, so it allows oxygen to diffuse from the water directly into the bloodstream. But wasn't the plant supposed to generate enough oxygen for the snails? Yes, it was, but it decided to let the underwater leaves die. And they were a nice source of food for the snails, but the new leaves developed outside the bottle, and so did the oxygen from their own. And now the big question, is the bottle ecosystem still alive after 1 year? Well, as you can see, it's somehow alive. These snails usually don't live over a year, so their shells are rotting in the bottom, but they are providing the calcium their offspring needs to grow. There's also a big population of sea shrimps, so oxygen is still present in the water. And the plant is still alive, and is still outside of the bottle. There's no leaves inside, only roots. So I think the answer is yes, the bottle ecosystem is doing okay after such a long time. It would be doing better if it was bigger, just like it happens with this other ecosystem I have.